What's going on, guys? We're gonna do some catfishing, crappie fishing. Yeah, we're in Shawnee, Oklahoma at Twin Lakes. I came out last night and I dropped some jugs for catfishing, and we're gonna go out this morning and do a little bit of crappie fishing, hitting some brush piles on the spots, and then we're gonna go get the jugs and see if we had any luck. I didn't do anything super special on the jugs. Got kind of lazy, just using straight up hot dogs. None of that voodoo garlic salt and jello crap or anything. I don't think that's never actually made a difference for me, using the extra crap on the hot dogs. So, like I said, we're gonna go hit some spots, and then we'll go see what the jugs have. I got my new minnow live well right there, rocking and rolling. I picked that up with my birthday money from Academy. Let's get this little low and that 60 horse back there. Let's see if we can light it up. Spot. Let's creep up on it and see what we see. I've got the other camera on the live scope. I don't know if you can see it on the screen or not. I've got a clamp. I put the GoPro on my screen on the back, and then I throw a towel over it to keep the glare out. But man, it's a beautiful morning. We've had some scattered storms coming through. It's been hotter than the seventh plane of hell here in Oklahoma the last couple weeks. So this is a super nice break to have. So you can probably see it coming on the screen right now. This is one of the brush piles we're going to check first. Get up here on it. There's the other one. Point us into the wind a little bit. Get some spot lock action. We are going to go with a 10-foot rod with a loose. Loose spinning reel, I like those. And see if we can get a feisty minnow. Gonna nose hook this guy. This is why I like having my live scope transducer on a separate pole. You guys that have it on your trolling motor, that's cool if that works for you, but seems like I'm always pointing it in the wind. Oh, get one? Nope. Come off. I'm always pointed into the wind, it looks like, or seems like, and I don't like the idea of having to constantly adjust that trolling motor to keep the live scope on target. I mean, it just the way that I like to fish, I guess. I don't know. Thank you.
we got them. We got these little teeny tiny ones just dialed in. Come here, dude. Oh boy, it's gonna be one of them mornings. Caught that. Yep, another bluegill.
Since the crappie fishing isn't working out, I figured I'd go check my jugs and see what's happening. So far, three jugs, two catfish. I didn't measure them, they're big enough. But two of the jugs, I put them too close together, and so they were all twisty. So I may have had three for three. Now we've got one, two, three or four more right here. We're gonna go check this orange one. Set it in the right direction, feet away. Oh yeah, I think there's one on there. Oh yeah, there's one on there. What's up, buddy? What's up, my man? You are going in my belly for dinner. And I've got two right there. I think I saw one right over there too.
Kind of the same thing. I think this is blank. I think this is a blank. Yep. Strike out. Wah, 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 wah. One right there. I think that's another blank.
So I ended up with 5 catfish. All the crappie I caught today were little teeny tiny. I think I caught 1 9 or 10 incher, and it just wasn't worth keeping one. Guys, if you liked the video, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Let's get to cleaning some fish. Another quick tip, I'm trying something new I haven't done before, cleaning catfish. I've heard about it, seen a couple videos. If you want to kill them easy or whatever, and you want to get the meat clean and white and all that good stuff, cut the tail off and hang them up and bleed them out. Let the blood go out. It'll kill them and it'll get the redness out of the meat. Let me show you what I'm talking about.